Hello there! This time we are going to make a salubri anti-tribu. The core difference from a salubri from an anti-tribu version is that the anti-tribu is a warrior type, where the normal salubri is a healer type. I'm putting some starting points indicating what we're going to use our disciplines or magic, and as you can see, it's not much. It's only perception and empathy, and you're both using perception and empathy for Auspex and from Valinor. At least for the three first dots. Up here we have 7, 5, and 3 points we can spend. I will suggest, since we are fighting type, that we use 7 points in our physical, then 5 in our mental, and 3 in our social. In my opinion, there's 3 ways to putting these dots. The one way, if we are using 7, is to even them out, like this, using 7. That way we're not bad at anything, we're not good at anything, really. But we won't have to struggle, and if you are a new player, that could be a good way to just get a feeling of the game. And then there is the role-playing phase, meaning that you are trying to figure out what character you are and why they have the dots they have. So you are like, before you got bitten, you were a professional boxer, and your dots look like this. Is that 7? Yes. You hit hard, you hit kind of precise, but you were knocked out easily. And then there is the last way, that is the XP based, meaning that you put your dots the most efficient way for not losing experience, meaning that if you are doing it like this, it will not take you so much experience to get your stamina up to this and have like 4 in everything and 5 in strength, as it would take you if you did like the balanced way, because it costs 4 experience per dot that's up here, meaning that if we wanted 2 more dots here and 1 more dot here, it would cost us for a 12 extra, then 12 extra again, that's 24, and then 16, meaning we would use 40 experience to increase it. But if we did it like this, we would only use like 4, then 8 more, that's 12, and 12 more, that's 24. So that would only cost us 24 to get it up here. I am building this the XP based way. Later on, you're going to use your, I think it's stamina, to make a shield. So it's good to have a high stamina and then high dex, because one of your abilities also drives on dex later on. And I will get back to why I'm explaining the higher level abilities. Then I would do it like this. It's good to have at least 2 in intelligence, so you are like average smart. You're not like brilliant, but you're not stupid. And then depending on what kind of social person you would be, you could either increase your charisma so everyone likes you, you can manipulate people, or you are good looking but people hate you. If you're using it XP wise, I find that you use your manipulation the most when you are playing, but just for shits and giggles, I will put it in appearance. Then down here we have 13, 9, and 5 points. Since we are only using empathy here, that's kind of hard to see where you will use the most point. So what I usually do is I put 1 point in everything I want to have and then fill it out. Up here you can only increase your abilities to the maximum of 5 dots, and down here the maximum of 3 dots. I will put 1 dot in everything. I think that most characters should have at least one in. So one in alertness, so you see if people are sneaking up on you. Athletics, so you can dodge attacks and hit people with throwing weapons. Then brawl, so you can grapple people and drink their blood, so you don't have to struggle that much, especially with our only one strength. Empathy, to see if people are lying or how they feel. And then I would have at least one in streetwise, so you can get around town. And subterfuge, you actually have a chance of actually lying. You don't have to tell the truth all the time. Then I would take at least 1 dot in one of these fighting abilities beside brawl, just so you can defend yourself, firearms or melee. But since that we are at least going to fight with melee weapons, because many of these abilities are dependent on melee, and I would suggest to at least have one in firearm, since you are a fighter. One stealth, so you can sneak around. Drive is a good thing to have, but not crucial. One in academics, so you can read and write. Investigations, you can find things you are looking for. It's also called search in secondary abilities, but most people use investigation since it's on the sheet. At least one in occult, so you know about basic stuff about the magical world. And these are the dots I think you should at least have one in. Then we can look on what we actually want to have. It would be good to have some more. And we can see here that we have. Oh yeah, sorry. We want to have at least one in awareness, so we can see magical stuff when that's happening. Intimidation is good too, because one of our abilities could rely on intimidation. Drive would not be bad to have. Lastly, so we can break in locks and security. That's maybe crafts, so we can repair our weapons if they break. Then I think we're good here. If it's modern day, it's good to have at least one in computer. It's not a must, but it's good. Since we are a Salupi and a tribute, it wouldn't be bad for us to have medicine, and maybe science or poison is a secondary ability, it's called. So you can make poisons, mostly against mortals, but you don't have to have it to create, maybe just so you know that what medicine actually does. Then we have actually already used our 5 points here. I don't think much of it should be increased at the beginning. We at least have to have 3 in empathy, since that's 2 of our vampire ability are mostly solely based on perception empathy. Then we want to have some. What have we used here? 7, 8, 9, 10 points. And then we have used what? 6 here. 7, 8, 6, 8. What should we do? I think we will use 9 points here and then 13 points here. With this up here, there's also an XP way to do it. If I just remove the one occult, so it's little bit easier to see what's happening. To get 1 point in something you don't have, it costs 3 experience, and then 2 per dot you want to have increased, like 1 times 2 is 2, and 2 times 2 is 4. But if we use 3 dots here, we have used 3, 6, and 9 points. If we do it like this, we have used 3, then 2 more, that's 5, and 4 more, that's 9. But if we do it like this, we use 3, 6, and then 8 experience points. So this, you will lose 1 experience point, but it could be crucial for your character to have that extra dot. But 1 experience is not much, but if you fill everything out with 2, you will maybe lose like 10 experience. So here we have 6, 8, we have 1 dot left. We could either increase something we actually want to have at 2, or just take 1 we think we will need. if we want to get some status and respect from the elders, maybe some etiquette would be nice. Then we have 13 points. Alertness is something that's very good to have. Athletics, so you can dodge attack, that's 6, 9, 12. And we used one too many. So maybe alertness a little down. We have a high perception, so that should be fine. 6, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have one dot more. Since we're a warrior, leadership wouldn't be bad. Or you could not have awareness and put two dots in something. But I like to have at least one in most stuff. Because the difference from you from having zero to one is that if you have nothing, the difficulty for you to try it anyway is three higher. Meaning that if you want to hit someone with a dagger and you have zero in melee, it's not difficulty 4, it's difficulty 7. And if you have at least one, it's difficulty 4. If you have two, it doesn't change, it's still difficulty 4. Then we have 3 points in our disciplines. Auspex 1 makes that you can increase your senses. You can hear better, smell better, see better, feel better. 2, you can see auras, meaning that you can recognize if someone is mages, vampires, werewolves, so on. And with 3, you can touch object and see the last great emotion that were near that object and see a kind of ghostly figure of what happened. So if you get into an apartment and someone is been killed, you can touch maybe the table in the middle of the room and see who killed him, and maybe a little what they said. Fortitude just increases your stamina for each dot you have. Not that if you do it like this, you have to increase it like this. It's not like that. You just, when you have to soak damage, you roll the 4 here plus the 2 here. But the special ability about having Fortitude is that you can soak what is called aggravated damage, and I will explain quickly what that is. There's 3 kinds of damage. There's bashing. I hit you with my fist. You probably not gonna die, but it will hurt. Then there's lethal. I stab you with a knife. You're probably going to die, and it hurts a lot. Then there is aggravated damage. That is fire, sunlight, magic. Acids, lasers, so on. And that can fortitude soak. I want to say something more. You as a vampire can only soak bashing and lethal, and this allow you to be able to soak aggravated with a dice pool equal to your fortitude. So if someone throws fire at you and you have 2, you can try to soak some of it. Then we come down to the Valoran. With the first dot, you can see the first two dots is kind of the opposite of the Salubri ability. When you touch someone with your hand with the first dot, you can see what illness they have and how you can increase their death. So it's not like you see, oh, they are very sick, maybe I can fix it. No, it's how can I make it worse. The second one, you can put people to sleep against their will, and with 3 points you can with a touch torture people. It will feels like you are burning them with a hot metal bar. You can use that when you are in combat, and most likely it will be used for torturing to get informations or just for fun. But as long as you are holding a grip on the one you are burning, they will lose 2 dice for every thing they're trying to do. So as long as you can get a grip, they will actually have a harder time actually using their abilities and try to fight you off. You have 3 points, and here there's also an XP based, a balance based, and a role playing based. But I think I figured the balance and the role playing based. If you want to do it, the experience base is like this. It costs 10 experience to start a new ability, so that's 30 experience points, and then 5 for each dot you already have. So if you put it like all space, that's 15, and then 25. So you will get the most experience of doing this. And an all space 1 and a fortune 1 and a Valinor 1 is not bad, it's not great either. But depending on how you want to play, I'm a big fan of aspects when they are usable by the playstyle. Fortitude is always good to have because some creatures just inflict aggravate damage as basic, and Valinor is not very good for combat until you get the 4th and 5th dot. Because the 4th dot you make a holy shield, you get a halo over your head, and for every success you get for a maximum of 5, you get 1 extra die to lethal damage. So let's say we actually had 4, and we get 5 successes, we actually have 9 dice for every lethal damage. That's a huge amount. And if you have fortitudes combined, let's say you gain some experience, you have 13. Yeah, 13 dots of soaking and 4 of them for aggravated. So that's a very good way of protecting your character. It's one of the few that has so many dice, quote unquote, that easily. And you have an easier way of not going into panic when you see fire and so on by 1 die extra per 2 successes you get. And the 4th one is that you hit with all your dex and melee, so that will be 8 dice you automatically hit with, and the person you are hitting cannot dodge it, but you can only use it with a solo attack. I don't know if they mean your starting attack or just if you only use one attack, but that's an extremely good way of just killing someone off. And I'm not sure because it don't specify it, but if you're aiming for something, the difficulty for you to hit becomes higher. But if you hit, no matter what, you just have to hit them in the eye, that's 3 dice of damage more on your attack. That's your strength plus your weapon plus 3 extra dice. That just seems insanely good. And if you want to stake a vampire, he cannot dodge it, and you get 2 extra dice because you hit for the heart. That just seemed very, very good. A problem with the Valinor spell is that in the Vampire 20 Years Anniversary book, called Rulebook, it only increases to the level of 6, where every other one has to 9. Some only have to 5, but then they have paths and a lot of other powers that balance it out. They don't have it. But if you get the Salubri clan book, and that is not the 20 years anniversary, so they're probably going to get a new one out, but then they actually have the abilities up to 10. That's that's weird, because normally only 2 to 9. But the 10th ability is that you actually can resurrect people. That's extremely good, and you can also put, I think that's written that you can put other people's souls into the dead man's body, so it don't have to be the original. You can make like flame swords and holy flame sword and so on. But to get back to the issue, I will take Valinor to 3, unless you think that you just want to defend yourself, and later on when you need these 2 last abilities, you will get it, because get fortitude 3 from the beginning plus your high stamina is not bad. But I will do it like that. This I know it's not XP based, but yeah. Then there is something little unique. This kind of a new clan, meaning that generation can only and you have to put one in generation as minimum, but it can only be increased to 3 because Valinor, Salubri and Tribune cannot get their generation below 10 because their clan is so new. And Salubri and Tribute works primarily with the Sabbat, is the evil vampires, and hate Tremere's, the mage vampires, the most, and try to kill off Camarilla, that is the quote-unquote good vampires. But then, and we have 5 dots here to put, then we actually have, we are actually forced to take something other than generation. That's a little bit fun. So we can take resources, have more money, or we have like people we feed from. Oh yeah, their vampire weakness, I will just go over that fast, is that the normal Salubri cannot feed from people that don't want to be fed from. These had the opposite. You have to violently try to feed from them against their will, or mid-combat you have to make them really hate that you are feeding. So if you're trying to attack someone and they're like, oh, you're a vampire, just drink, like, damn it, then it's no fun. And if you want to feed from them anyway, you don't get any blood points back. So it's useless. But contacts, which if you are a fighter, is not bad. So you know someone that can give you some weapon or car or so on, or maybe some allies, a policeman or something. Yes. Then we have 7 points here. Constant is that are you able to kill people without get any decreases. Self-control, if you are smelling blood or you really want something, can you control yourself? And courage is if you see fire or sunlight, do you run in terror? Since we want to fight a lot, I think conscience is very good. And again, the higher you have it, the more experience you quote-unquote gain by doing it. And then some courage. I think that's the best way. You can just kill off, or you can put it like this if you don't want to flee in combat, or if you like, I want to have a few dices when blood really lures me in. But your conscience and your self-control combined are your humanity. That's how human you are. The higher you are, like when you have 10, you're like a saint. You don't want to feed from people that don't want you, don't want to do anything that you can gain from, just want to help people. And if you have 1, you just want to sleep, kill and feed. And if you lose your last bit of humanity, you cannot play as a playable character. You go into a frenzy animal instinct way. So keep it like in the middle if you want to do stuff. Like 4 to like 7 is fine, in my opinion, if you want to fight. And then your courage combined, your courage is equal to your willpower. I'm not quite sure when you're generation 10 how much blood you have, but I think it is like 12 blood points you have, or maybe 11, maybe 13, I think. And you can use like 1 blood point. I think when you are generation 9, you can use 2 and have 14 blood points. Your weakness, can't drink unless they don't want to. This is your health. When you put on a dot, is like bashing, is when you got hit with a fist. Lethal are the cut here, and aggravated is the X. And the highest amount of damage should be the last one you have. So if you had like bashing, and then you get 1 lethal and then 1 aggravated, it should look like this instead. Like bashing, lethal, aggravated. Because when you have to count how fast you heal, if you get aggravated here and you want to heal it and you can't, that doesn't stop you from healing all the other damage. That's just a little side note. Your blood you can use to different stuff, and you can only use one, so it's not that powerful. I think it's one. You can use blood to heal your lethal or below damage, equal to how much blood you can use. So here you can use like one. And if you were generation 8, you have 15 blood points and can use 3, so you heal 3 kind of free damage each turn. And you can use it to increase your physical attributes for one scene. So if you, before fighting, use 4 blood points because you use 1 each turn, you could get a high strength. But then you have to get your blood back at some point. Then there is flaws. You don't have to take any flaws, but both for role-playing sake and to power up your character, I will suggest you take some. And you can take it at the maximum point of 7. There could be bad sides, addiction and amnesia, death, deep sleeper, and each of these give a different amount of points. So let's say you have taken from 7 points. Then you have the starting point of freebie points of 15 plus the 7, that's 22. Then you can use that to buy the opposite, merit, and you can use all your points or none of them. But then you can get an additional discipline, it's one of my favorites, so if you want to have like celerity, potence, dominate, so on. Someone owes you a boon, a favor, or whatever you want here. And these also cost different amount each, so I won't go through them all. But when you have bought that, oh, it's just one ability you should consider. It's something that's unique for Salubris, that's called Sight Beyond Sight, it costs 5. Salubris had a third eye in their forehead that's mostly closed, unless they use their unique Salubri abilities, and yours are Valenarn. But Sight Beyond Sight makes that you can see through illusions, invisibility, even through dimensions. You can see auras, you can see everything, so it's like a very improved Auspex, where you can see stuff beyond normal sight. The only downside from it is that you have to open your third eye, making this very clearly what clan you are, and you cannot control what you see. So depending on how your storyteller will tell it, like someone tries to make themselves invisible and try to find them, but because of you are in a mansion where the magical power is greater than the invisibility, you see a magical aura in the house, and maybe because there's a demon gate in the basement, you can see into the demon realms, and you cannot see the invisible person. Or it's like the opposite, like you see through the most easy to see through abilities and not the highest energy based illusions and flows. But that's a very useful ability. These up here cost 5 for each dot you want to increase, and it's not like 5 for each dot, like 5, 10, 15, 20. Yes! No, it's like 5, 5, 5, 5. Like this, and here it costs 2, and here you can actually increase it to more than 3 points, to maximum of 5, and also here maximum of 5. And these cost 7 to increase. XP wise is not that great, but for power wise that's very great. These cost 1 each, these cost 2 each, and willpower costs 1 each, and I suggest every player to increase your willpower, because that is how easy you are about resisting mind control and so on, and you can use it to get automatic successes like this. And then there is a few ways to get it back, and I will end the video with that. So I will increase it like max it out. We have 17 points left, and if I need a few points I can put it down again. It's not marked yet. I will, for HP wise, increase my appearance and my stamina. That's 10 points. You have 7 points left. That could be good to have, like one extra in fortitude. You cannot increase these to more than 3 dots. So that would be something that could be great. Maybe some backgrounds for 7 points, that's a lot. And maybe some merits for 7 points. And what could we use 7 points for? I think maybe we should have some more contact so we really know people. That's 6 points. Maybe some allies that can help us out. And we have resources, so we have some money to actually buy the stuff we need. It could look like this. You have the free will to place the dots as you want. Then you have to write what your sire, the one who created his name, were. Then you have to pick a nature, and that's one of the second last things we need. There's a nature and a demeanor. Your nature is how you are within when you are alone, and demeanor is how people see you. Meaning that you could be just write something. A badass, right? You just like trying to threaten people, like, well, what you gonna do, man? Hey, I'm going to kill you. But when you are with friends, you are a caregiver. So if someone is threatening your friend, like, oh, okay, don't hurt them. So it's like, how are you with strangers and other people, and how are you with your friends, basically. And if you fulfill your nature, like help, like caregiver, you want to help your friend, you regain the will, some of the willpower you have used. If you use like this to hit someone 3 times, and you use free willpower, if you help some of your friends, you will get it slowly back. There's also the optional rule that you get 1 willpower back for every day you do nothing, just rest up, like really just do nothing, maybe except feeding from someone who wants to get, be fed from us, or you, yeah, fine. Then the last thing is that you have to get specialties, and that's for every one of these down here, or and this up here that has 4 dots or higher. Meaning that your stamina could be tireless. So if you are running and the storyteller tells you to make a stamina athletics roll, your 10s will count as 2 successes instead of 1, making it a little bit easier to just keep on running. Or your perception could be inside, you are, so you try to find someone that's perception streetwise, so your inside, you talk to a lot of people on the street, try to find them, and the 10 counts as 2 successes, so it's a little bit easier to find the person you are looking for. And down here too, if you have anything at 4 or higher. I think that will do it. I hope that helped you. See you. Bye.